Thanks for clicking on BlueHens.com. I'm Jessica Filipek, standing here with head coach Monte Ross. After the Blue Hens just defeated Georgia State University in double overtime, 77-74. Coach, first off, congratulations. Coming off of a three-game loss streak, it's got to feel good to bring a win back to the Big Bob. Tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely it is. And this was a very, very important ball game for us. One, because Georgia State being such a quality ball club, to get a win like that against them is be huge for our confidence. Another thing, like you said, coming off of a three-game winning losing streak, we needed to try to get back on track, right the ship a little bit, and I think this win will do that for us.
What sort of things did you work on specifically in practice to come out, make a statement, and get the win?
Well, the last two games, we know they're a zone team. They don't play any man-to-man. So we've been working very hard on our zone offense for the last 2 days. And, you know, we worked on not just shooting jump shots, but getting the ball inside against their zone. And I was happy that we were able to do that. We were able to get some easy buckets. And I think that gave us some confidence. And it softened them up a little bit and allowed us to get some open jump shots as well.
Also, your defense was very key tonight. You guys had 11 blocks on the down in their territory. So defense is something that you obviously capitalize on.
No, we did. We did. And we're traditionally a very good defensive team. We've been all year. And they are, too. So it was important that we got some key blocks and got some key rebounds and got some key stops. And, you know, for us, it starts and ends with defense. And I was glad that our defense, we had some really key stops down there at the end of the game tonight, and I was glad our defense came through for us.
And the beginning of the game, you guys were actually down 13-0, and then Jarvis came in and was just, you know, hitting threes. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Jarvis is a really, really talented kid, and he has a lot of ability to score the ball and make buckets, and it was very timely today that he came in the basketball game and made them, because we needed. He was 5 for 5 from three, and we needed every last one of those threes in the first half. And then he just continued it in the second half, which I was very, very proud of him and happy for him that he was able to break through in today's game.
Thanks, Coach. Speaking of Jarvis Threatt, he's standing by with Tim Donnelly.
Thanks, Jess. I'm standing by alongside Jarvis Threatt, who just broke the school freshman scoring record held by his teammate Devon Sadler and Kent Luck. Jarvis, how did it feel to get the record today?
Well, really, I'm more excited about the victory, so first of all, but, you know, it feels great. I didn't actually know until I did the first interview, so, and they told me, you know, I don't even really think my teammates know, but, you know, Devon told me he had like 30 or something, but I ain't gonna let that be talked about, but, you know, it just feels great, you know, and getting this victory, and hopefully we can string some wins together.
Like you said, 30 points, but you care more about the victory. No, none of those points were more important than the six you had in the second overtime. How did it feel going to the line, getting that open layup, and really putting your team in a position to win?
Well, actually, my coaches put me in a position to win. You know, we're shooting 100 free throws a day in the gym, so really you just stepping up there is routine. You know, I just pretend like it's nobody in the crowd, and I'm just shooting, you know, in practice with the team. So really I just felt great about those free throws.
And I hate to bring it up, but the beginning of the game was a little rough for your team. You went down 0-14, but you came off the bench and gave him a little bit of a spark. Is that your role on the team?
Yeah, really to just come off the bench and, you know, not necessarily even scoring, you know, just defense, 50-50 balls, steals, rebounds, and then scoring. So really just do a little bit of everything. And if we start off slow, you know, it's my role to just come in and try to pick us up a little bit.
Six consecutive threes made, one away from the record. Did the basket look big for you today, or were you just feeling it? How did it feel to be in the zone like that?
Every shot I took, I just knew it was going in. But it didn't. But really, that shot felt great over there. It was just a little strong, and I guess you can tell on my face that I really wanted that one. I had no idea about the record, but I just felt like I could have made the shot. So,
all right, thanks, Jarvis. Congratulations.
All right, thank you.
Hens get the win 77-74 over surprising CAA power Georgia State to knock them to 5-3 in the conference while boosting the Hens record to 4-4. Hens return to the Bob at 7 p.m. Monday against Towson on ESPN3. For Jarvis Threatt, head coach Monte Ross, Jessica Filipek, I'm Tim Donnelly. Thanks for clicking on BlueHens.com.